The XLOOKUP function in Excel takes your limited VLOOKUP skills to a whole new level. If you found yourself frustrated with the strict rules of searching left to right, XLOOKUP opens the possibilities for a multi-directional search to find your values. I've got several examples to simplify its power for you, so let's get started. In this first example, we want to look up the letter grade for each student based on their grade average. Start by entering the formula and choose the lookup value, which is the grade average in column C. The lookup array is where we can expect to find a match. In this case, it's the legend at the bottom under column A. Be sure to lock your cells so the range is the same when we copy the formula down. After the comma, enter the array to be returned, which is the letter grade in the legend. Now, before we cover some of the other options, like how to handle missing values and match mode, let's lock the cells again. Close the parentheses and hit enter. Now drag the formula down. Not surprising, but we only had one match. Instead of using a nested if formula to detect the grade ranges, we can use one of the options in the XLOOKUP to do it for us. Go back to the first XLOOKUP and enter two more commas at the end. This shows your four choices for search mode. Exact match is the default and isn't required if that's your intention. In our case, we want to use -1 to find an exact match or the next smaller item. This way, if we search for the grade average of 82, Excel will use the next lowest match if 82 doesn't exist. Hit enter and drag down the change to the other cells. Next, let's use XLOOKUP with multiple criteria. There's more than one way to do this, so let me show you the first, but maybe not the most direct. Here are three drop-down cells, and depending on the selections, we want XLOOKUP to find a student name that meets all criteria. Enter the start of the function, and for the lookup value, use the number 1. What we're going to do is set three conditions, and if each condition is true, it'll match to the number 1, which is the binary equivalent to true. For the lookup array, I'll type in the first condition within parentheses. We want to see if the teacher's name in column D is equal to the name in our dropdown. Close the parentheses and enter an asterisk, which tells Excel to find a match for more than one condition. Now enter the second criteria just like the first, only this time we want to find a match to the age. Again, use the asterisk for a third condition and set the lookup to find a matching letter grade. Next, we define our return array, which is the student's name in column A. But before closing out the function, let's tell Excel how to handle a return error. You can do this however you'd like, but I'll enter no results in double quotes. I won't bother entering a match mode since it defaults to exact match. Enter the function with the closing parentheses and be sure to lock in all your references before hitting enter. Now, each time I change a parameter, we get the desired result. Just remember that the XLOOKUP works the same as the VLOOKUP, as it will return the first value it matches to. If you wanted all matching values, you're better off using a filter function. However, we can change the search mode of XLOOKUP to start searching from the bottom up. Simply go back into the formula, add two commas before the last parentheses, and enter -1 to reverse the order. I'll show you another way to do this in a moment, but first let's talk about using this function with wildcards, as most avid Excel users are sure to want to learn. Below our grades, we have a section for the most improved student. We'll pretend that the principal emailed us to let us know that the student's name is Jen. While that's not exactly helpful, we can use that information to find a match in our list. Enter the start of the XLOOKUP, and for the lookup value, type the name Jen, followed by an asterisk in double quotes. The asterisk is our wildcard that signifies unknown characters after the initial text. For the lookup array, we'll use the student's name column and repeat it for the return array. We don't have to lock in our cells since we're only pulling one name from the list. But before closing out the function, we must choose a match mode of number 2. Whenever you search with a wildcard, XLOOKUP requires you to define the existence of a wildcard in the formula. Otherwise, it treats it as simple text. Close the parentheses and hit enter to see the results. We did find a Jennifer in the list of students, but if you look closely, there is also a Jenny. We could set the search mode to look in reverse order, but in a longer list, that doesn't guarantee you'll find all possible matches. This is where something like the filter or unique function would come in handy. Before we get to the next example, I want to show you two more ways to build on this wildcard lookup. For instance, if you wanted to return more than just the name, like the entire row or just another column, you only need to change the return array argument. If I change the return array to pull both column A and B, I get the student's name and their age. Depending on the structure of your sheet, you might want to return the student age below the name. To do that, wrap the transpose function around the XLOOKUP. This is a quick trick to use in place of two different lookup formulas. For the last example of using the XLOOKUP function in Excel, let me show you a second way to search with multiple criteria. This time we'll search for a match horizontally across a data range. Again, I have two drop-down lists that take the available teacher names and the month of the year. We want to use this in an XLOOKUP to return the correct class grade average. Instead of using the asterisk to set multiple conditions, we can use a nested XLOOKUP function to do the same thing. Start with your formula and enter the first lookup value from the teacher dropdown. Set the lookup array as the choices in column A. After the comma, we'll define the return array as an alternate lookup by typing the XLOOKUP function again. Choose the second dropdown field as the lookup value, and set the lookup array as the month headers. Lastly, the final return array will be the range of grades between B2 and M4. Enter two closing parentheses to complete the function and hit enter. As you change the parameters in the dropdowns, the XLOOKUP finds the intersection points and returns the grade average in the cell. And that's it. In my opinion, XLOOKUP is a more versatile function than what many are used to with the other lookup options. But while I'm happy to sing its praises, it's not perfect. When it comes to returning multiple matches or factoring in some calculation choices, you might be better off with another formula that's tailored more appropriately for your needs.